Hi, here's a question for you. What do you get when you cross a baby boomer with an entrepreneur? A boomerpreneur, and that's me, Jean Newell. I invented a product called the PUP, the Personal Utility Pouch, and I'm about ready to launch my newest product, the Gizmo Bag. What do you think of that, Donnie?
Jean, you go launch, girl, we're ready.
Of misplacing your belongings? Well, how about not having enough room to carry all of your necessities with you? Straight ahead, we're going to introduce you to the new personal utility pouch. This isn't for your average fanny pack. It's for boys and for girls, Tom. Yes. You're watching Fox 35 News. We'll be back.
I'm solid gold. I've got the goods. I invented it when I was in real estate, and I was constantly calling my own cell phone. I don't know. That's happened to everybody. I found out that's a universal problem, not just a realtor problem.
So necessity out of this invention
necessity,
here.
Necessity, because I was getting forgetful in my old age.
Guess what? We have a really great thing for everybody in the audience. You know, a lot of people walk around carrying all kinds of stuff. You carry ladies, got purses so big that it's kind of crazy. We have this new thing. It's called the PUP pouch. PUP stands for Personal Utility Pouch. Everybody's going to go home with one. It's unisex. It's durable. You get to carry it. It's like a little man purse thing, okay? And so everybody in the audience is going to get one of those to take home.
I want to show you guys the PUP personal utility pouch, because this is something.
Oh,
can you show that?
I got one. Thank you.
I'm so glad you like it. I love it.
Love
all right.
It.
But it has all these compartments for your cell phone, your keys, everything while you're walking the dog.
Perfect.
So yeah, especially when it's warm out and you're just in your sweats. So everyone in the audience is going home with one today. You're going to
Fountain of Youth, Fearless Boomer Starting Over. Jean Newell is a self-proclaimed boomerpreneur who launched her own successful business. You had this great product in mind, but what were your personal circumstances when you decided to launch this business?
Strictly out of necessity, I was in real estate and I was juggling five electronic devices all day long, in and out of cars in the office. I said, there's got to be a better way.
Traveling though, because you need a place to put your airline ticket, because aren't you always stuffing it in a jacket or in your back? You know, so this would be great for stuffing the ticket in here and the other stuff.
You're right.
See, ladies, it's small enough to put in the handbag when you're going through airport security, because you know you can only bring one carry-on and then one personal bag. So
absolutely.
It goes
on your hip. You've got both hands free.
Most mothers don't want to hear, "Here, Mom, hold this for me. I don't want to carry it all day." So now every member of the family can have their own pup and their own favorite color.
Absolutely.
It's called a PUP, a personal utility pouch. It has a compartment for your phone, business cards, or whatever you lug around. A fanny pack, you say. A man purse? Newell says, no way.
It looks like a tool belt.
Jean, you got a big break. You took your product and QVC accepted your product.
Yes, that
That's like a business in a bottle right there. All of a sudden, you're launched.
Mm-hmm.
And so how big a deal was that for
you? It was a big deal. I flew back and forth to Philadelphia from Orlando 35 times in 18 months. They sold over 100,000 of these in record time.
So you're firmly entrenched now. You've got a viable business on your hands. So she's a success story.
Having an idea is one thing, but having the belief in it to risk money, to risk time, to risk effort, and to risk humiliation is another thing. What made you believe in it so much, or believe in your ability to make it work?
Sometimes I wonder myself. Every day is a struggle, but every day you have to believe in yourself. After all, if you don't believe in yourself, who else is going to?